Hello, welcome to SS Unitech, Sushil this side, and this is continuation of CECO Server interview questions and answers. So today we are going to discuss one more interview question, and this is very tricky question. So characters occurrence in a column. So what is this question? So move to next slide to understand about the question. So here, as we can see, we have input table and it contains two columns. First is ID and second is name. In the output, we are having only two columns. First is character and second is their occurrence. So here, as we can see in the name, we are having Joanne, Howard, Rosie and John. So we have total four rows. So J is coming two times. First in the Joanne and second in the John. So in the output, as we can see, for J, occurrence is 2. Second for O, so O is coming one time in Joanne, one time in Howard, one time is Rosie and one time in John. So total O would be 4. So occurrence is 4. So how we can get this output from this input? So let's move to SQL Server Management Studio, where we will write the query and get the output. So as I am using SQL 2017, you may have another versions of SQL Server. So first of all, I would like to create the table so we can execute this query. So query is executed successfully. Now here I just want to insert data on the table. So we can execute this insert statement. Now I just want to check the data, so we can execute this select statement. So we are having the same metadata as we seen in the slide. So here I just want to create this output table that would have character and their occurrence. So character will be second column and total will be the occurrence. So we can execute this create table statement. So table is created. Now our logic will be started. So here first I need to check how many number of rows we have, and then we need to pull one by one and loop through their strings. So here I need to declare few variables. So first of all, I would like to declare first variable, that is I, and data type is integer and value is 0. Next, I want to declare one more variable, that is k, and it would have varchar and this is 100. So next variable, I just want to declare for the length, so @l, data type is integer and value is 0. So I have declared three variables, and I just want to put value in the @i variable. So I just want to get the number of rows. Select @i is equals to, here I just want to use the count of 1 from our input table. So that is string IQ table. So next, I just want to declare one more table. So declare @j, and this is a table and it would have only one column, that is name. Data type will be varchar and value is 1. So we have done with the declaration of variables. Now I just want to use a loop. So while this @i is greater than 0, this loop will be executed. So we can use the begin then end. So inside this begin end, we need to implement our logic. So first, I just want to get the name one by one into @k variable. So I can use select then @k is equals to name. From here we can use our table, that is string IQ table, where ID should be equals to @i. And here we need to take care one more thing, like in the name we should use ltrim and rtrim. If we will have any blank spaces, then those blank spaces will be removed. Next, I need to use one more loop. So while @k value is greater than 0, then this loop will be executed. So begin then end, and in between we can apply our logic. Next, I just want to insert data into our @j table, and we want select left at the rate k comma 1. So we just want insert only single character from the at the rate k variable. Then here we want to use the merge statement. So merge, then our output table. So let me copy this. This is our target table. So let me call this as t. Then using, and here we need to use at the rate j table. Let me call this as source table. Then we need to specify on condition. So t dot character. So this is character should be equals to s dot name. Now when it gonna match, then what we want to do? So if matched, then I just want to update. So we can use the update, then set total should be equals to total plus 1. Next, when not matched by target, it means data is not available in the output table. So then we just want to insert data. So insert and character comma total, and values will be coming from source. So it should be s dot name comma 1, because it is first occurrence. So we have done our logic. Now we need to use semicolon to terminate this merge statement. So we have done the merge statement. Now we just want to use the set at the rate k value, right? And here at the rate k comma length of at the rate k minus 1. So this value will be initialized in the at the rate k. And here we again need to check if we have any blank space, then that blank space should be removed. So we can use ltrim and rtrim. So ltrim and rtrim. Again, we need to use ltrim and rtrim. After this, we just need to delete data from at the rate j table. Now we have done our inner loop, and outside this loop we have one more loop. So here set at the rate I is equals to at the rate I minus 1. Now we have done the logic. Now let me execute this and check the output. Initially in the output table we don't have any data. So let me copy it, and just I wanna check it. So select asterisk from table. Now execute this. We don't have any data. Now I just wanna execute this query. So here, okay, I made a mistake. Here we can't directly check. Here we need to check the length of this at the rate k. If length of this at the rate k is greater than 0, then we want the in the output. Now let me execute this, and here as we can see, this is executed successfully. Now we can execute and check the output. So here as we can see, j is coming 2 times, o is coming 4 times, then h is coming 2 times. So we can compare, and we are getting the same output as we are expecting. So we have total 11 rows and we are getting their occurrences. So this query is very simple if we can understand step by step. So here first I have declared few variables. Those are going to use in the query. So in the query first I have checked like if we have 4 rows or 5 rows or n number of rows. So it will be going to execute this loop for all the rows. Then we need to fetch data from the source table one by one, and name will be setting in the at the rate k variable. And here if the length of this at the rate k variable is greater than 0, then we want to execute our inner loop. And inside this loop I just want to insert data on this temporary table, that is table variable, and we just want only one character from this @k. Then I just want to use the merge statement with the output table using @jtable, where I have put the only single character. Then here we have on condition. If value is matched, then we just want to increase this total value, that is occurrence, by 1. If not matched, then we just insert with occurrence 1. And here we have fetch out all the characters except left one character. Then delete data from this @jtable. And here we have decreased the value of this @i, which is the total number of rows. So I hope you have understand how we can write the query and we can get this output. So this is a very tricky question. You can understand step by step, so that would very easy. So thank you so much for watching this video. If you like this video, please subscribe our channel to get many more videos. Don't forget to press the bell icon to get the notification of our newly uploaded videos. And if you need this script, it will be available on the description of this video. So thank you so much for watching.